Banished. Welcome back to Banished. We are banishing the thought of starvation from these people's minds, gradually. They didn't pick up the yield. They didn't pick it up. They're set to pick up. They haven't picked up anything. Harvest it, you bastards. Okay, so I mean, I put this storage barn down there, and my rationale is that they are having trouble walking from here to here, and so they're not gathering everything in time. It's not a huge loss. We are working on kind of a limited resource now. Do we have any fish to release into the population? I can't remember if I already released it all. Yeah, no fish to release in there, so that's kind of screwed. I guess we just have to rely on the idea that these pumpkins will pull through for us. We're good on everything else. Well, we really need to up our log production, actually. Yeah, firewood is low. I can understand that. Oh, there's no one working the fire. What are you doing? Why aren't you working? Work! There's definitely firewood cutters. What's going on here? I don't know what's going wrong here? Why can't you work? Okay, they've got no materials. Okay, that's understandable. I'll tell you what, let's have some cutting down done. Cut down all these trees. Okay, food has gone up substantially. That's good. And this will all be gathered hopefully before the end of winter, so they'll be ready to start the end of next winter, at the beginning of next spring. We're getting more labourers and stuff gradually. I might add an extra couple of farmers on. And put a slot extra on each of these so that they'll go and work whichever farm if you worked. We're in several difficult positions. The sheep have now gotten up the right stage for us to use them. Where are the leghorns? I remember getting leghorns. They're not in here. Did they die? There's no leghorns. I think our leghorns died in between this episode and the last episode. I mean, I'll set this to leghorn in case they're like wandering around our village. But I think we lost them. That's so depressing. I was really excited about those guys. Well, I guess we'll... Because they're not here. Let's pause this and check what this merchant has. I'm in a bit of a bad mood now. No, we don't want anything from that guy. He's just got ale. I've got bigger concerns. We're kind of running short on a lot of important things. I'm going to have all of these trees chopped down, and that's fine because we want to use this area for other stuff soon anyway. And it's not infringing on the trees grown by this guy. We have to set up another log cutter soon. This farm isn't being worked. Where the hell are the 16 farmers? Only 4 of them are doing their jobs. What are you doing? I think more are coming in now. Hopefully this will get built soon. We're running out of stone. Yeah, we've got no stone. Let's get some stone gathered. Reserve of tools is low. Well, that's a problem. You've got no logs. No, you've got no iron. Well, I've just set iron to be gathered. We're getting into a tight spot here because we are pushing up against the limits of my abilities. I am not that good of a banished player. So we'll see what we can do here. I'm really surprised at how fast we're consuming our food. But then again, we've got quite a large population at this point. Dangerous situation. We'll see how these crops go, and then we'll get a sense of what we need to do here. If they manage, like if the last time was just a fluke and now they'll be able to do it in the right time, then it won't be so bad. But I don't know, man, things could go bad pretty quickly here. Oh, our parish house is full. I'm going to leave it full because I don't really need it. I'm going to stop this, take you off here, and stop this from being worked. And we'll save it for when we next get chickens. We traded a lot for those chickens. I'm really annoyed about them disappearing. Probably my fault, though. I should have put them in captivity sooner. Okay, we've got plenty of clothes, so I'm going to take our tailor off of work. You're finally getting some work done. The tool limit's set pretty high so that we don't ever run into a problem with tools again. Oh, wow, fields are going really well. Early autumn, they're clearing everything out. It'd be better if this barn was made, but for now it's okay. They could really do with clearing out faster, and I haven't got really much way of controlling that. Yeah, it's late autumn and only half the fields have been cleared. We're going to start losing crops now. Yeah, we need more farmers, I think. Don't need any fruity rum, thank you. Dismiss. Okay, so look, this is not the most efficient farm system. We are losing a lot of our crops, like literally over half of our crops. But we are getting a net gain from them. So it's not such an awful situation. And I'd rather lose all of the crops than end up in a situation where we can't plant in the next season. Because if we set them all to, for example, set them all to pick up, we won't be able to, I'm going to put these on high priority, we won't be able to plant in the next season because they're all crops haven't been picked up, which means we won't be able to grow food, which means it'll be much worse than just losing some crops. Again, not an ideal scenario, but you know, there's a lot of non-ideal scenarios going on here. So I've put an extra farmer on each of these fields. Like I've created two more farmers, and I hate those noises because it means things are going bad. I've created an extra space for a farmer on each of these fields, and then put two more farmers on generally. Hopefully that means that these two farmers will go and do work where it's most appropriate, but honestly I can't guarantee that. Reserve of logs is low. I know it's low. Get through it as best you can, and we'll build a second forester over here. Now that this has been built, we should be in a better position. Like, they should clear their stuff a lot faster. This one still hasn't been cleared, which is causing problems. This farm's never going to start working. Or if it does, it'll be too late to do anything. But, I mean, we got a lot of pumpkins. Our people are living almost exclusively off pumpkins. Yeah, 1,404 pumpkins. I know logs is... Food's low. Food's not low, you liar. I know logs are low. I'm doing my best. Just cut it out, people. You know what I could do? I could shut the schoolhouse down and we'll instantly get 16 students. But it would be a big compromise in terms of our future efficiency. And I don't want to make that compromise yet. I mean, I think it's going fine. Early summer, all the crops are planted. This field's not planted, but we didn't expect that to be. We need more wood. Yeah, we need more wood because we're having a firewood issue. Actually, it's not going too badly now for firewood. You know what might be part of the issue? Is that these guys might not be able to get the food that they're making over there. But also, this population shouldn't be sustaining themselves off of their food. And this food should be enough for this population, so I think we're fine. But maybe I'm wrong. Okay, you brought lots of things that I just can't afford to trade for right now. So I'm going to dismiss you as well. I am going to set this up for a second row of houses, but also for... Well, the second row should have doors here, right? But also for the market that I'm going to put in to like make these the resource usage here a little bit more efficient. And that market's probably going to go in this vicinity. And it's going to be a big market. There you go, I've stuck a market down. We will see some... Wow, that field has been sorted out. Why has that field got so many... I don't understand it. Why did this field do so well? It hadn't even started yet. Doesn't make any sense. It says we've only got 9% of the yield. Something weird's going on here. I don't know what. But the pumpkins are all definitely being collected here, and now we have a ton of pumpkins. So, food is sorted. Even losing half of the yield, food is completely sorted. I fully understand that the reserve of logs is low. That is no one's problem but mine. So, I mean, we're just going to wait for this guy to finish with the log construction. I mean, he needs logs to do it. They're getting logs, but it's all being turned into other stuff. But we need the tools. Frustrating, very frustrating. Let's put some more people in this mine as well. Put an extra two people in the iron mine. It's getting enough iron that we can, I think, sustain our tool creation. Having all these clothes stored up is really helping us in our struggle. Why aren't... Okay, I hadn't turned pickup on. So that is why this field was doing so well. It didn't have pickup turned on, and that meant they were able to harvest it all a lot quicker. I'm going to experiment with leaving four of these fields, turning pickup off on these four fields. And then next season, hopefully, these guys will all be cleared and they can start their pickup immediately. We'll see how it works. Missing logs is not a big deal because we only need them to make firewood, and the reason we're missing so many logs is because they're all being turned into firewood, and they're being gathered at a reasonable speed. We need a bigger church. It's not necessarily one of the things we need to focus on right now because our happiness is great. Our health is poor, but our happiness is great. So we don't need to focus on that immediately, but it is a thing to think about. The other thing is to think about is that this place has no real... access to water if there's a fire, and that's something I'm very conscious of. They also are a bit far from the doctors, so I'm the herbalist, so that might be a thing to think of in the future as well. I'm going to give them a well, a well with a point, you know, not a useless well like the other village has. But I'm going to do that after the market's built, and hopefully there'll be no fires between then and now. I'm beginning to be very concerned about this tool situation. To the extent where I may even build... No, you know what? We don't need a second thing. We need more iron. So let's just get iron sorted. Where's a huge deposit of iron? It's loads here. Okay, here, and here, and also here. And then I'm going to give this the highest priority. Because if we run out of iron, we are buggered. If we run out of tools. So hopefully now these guys are going to go and gather all the things. But we haven't really got enough laborers to do a lot of things. That's the problem. We've caught education. It's finally trending back up. We've also caught food. If we look at our food graph, it should be crazy. Yeah. We've caught food. It should be trending back up. But in terms... Like, we could cancel the education and get a bunch of... Like, literally double our current... triple our current laborers. We can get them all right now. But it's too much of a sacrifice. I'm going to play the long-term game, and we're going to wait on those guys graduating. There's enough in there that they're graduating pretty regularly. But, I mean, I just don't know. We're about to see whether it makes a real difference to have pickup turned off. Okay, these guys have started harvesting. They've all started harvesting. But these guys are delivering their food. This should mean less loss, but also a slower start to these fields the next term. That's why we've started off... That's why these guys aren't... Oh, she died in childbirth. Sorry. That's why these guys aren't changed to pick up off. Because if these guys fail, we'll still have enough food with these guys. Although we've still got a ton of pumpkins from last year's harvest. The other benefit, if we can get enough farmers working these fields, is that once these guys have finished clearing, they'll help harvest and clear this one, or these other ones. So we saved a lot more crops that way. I'm going to turn pickup on now. Yeah, we saved a lot of crops that way, but now I don't know whether those fields will be ready for next year. We'll see how fast they pick things up. Basically then, since one field has been cleared, it's a little risky, but it works. No, we don't want any of you. What we need is iron and actually, well, tools still aren't going up really. God, we're in a dicey spot. You know what? I'm going to take a bunch of pumpkins and shove them in here. Like, literally 5,000 pumpkins. If I can find the pumpkins. Yeah, I'm going to put 5,000 pumpkins in here. And we're going to trade pumpkins. We were a fishing village. Now we're a pumpkin-in village. Pumpkin-ing village. Yeah, firewood's low. That's to be expected. It is winter, and also we've only got one fire cutter. Did I say fire cutter? I meant firewood cutter. A fire cutter would be someone who, like, throws swords into barbecues, I guess. it should be kind of... Well, I guess most people do that when they barbecue if they're not competent. Which I'm not. Also, I don't barbecue, so I don't know why I am. I don't know what I'm talking about. Let's keep hoping for salvation. Food is so sorted. This field system definitely works. Apart from this field hasn't been cleared yet. We just need more farmers to make this even more efficient, but... Like, it definitely works. We've put 5,000 pumpkins in here. That, well, they're probably not in there yet, actually. And it's still fine. Yeah, it's only 749. Okay, we're definitely still fine. We could use this... When we build the main village here... Well, I guess this has become the main village because there's so many more people there. But when this becomes the main village, it'll connect these two storehouses. So we won't be in a bad position. Like, this large market will overlap here and here. So the two villages start to grow pretty well. But we really need to get the log situation sorted first. Okay, there we go. I've doubled the forester numbers to 8, which has taken a lot of laborers away, but also it won't be a problem if we've got more wood. This is not the most efficient place to build a forester, I realise, but I was kind of panicking. And maybe we'll set up a forester in this area soon. This field is still not being worked. Which I guess is fine, because they'll go and work other fields. At least there's a small amount of emergency food if things go bad. They can all come over here and fight over pumpkins. The additional iron miners has seen good results. We may think about setting up another mine soon when this gets to, like, I don't know, 20%? But we're definitely getting good results out of the iron mine. How are you doing for logs? 35 logs, also 2 pieces of iron, which is interesting. Merchant, right. Let's see if he wants pumpkins. Do you want pumpkins? Let's pause the game. He does want pumpkins. You know what? Let's trade as many pumpkins as we can. We can't afford 33. We can't trade all of our pumpkins for jade statues. I may trade it for marble, though, because it's not too expensive. And, you know, it's diversification of resources. Okay, we can take 641 pumpkins off. Maths. I'd much rather just add pumpkins than subtract pumpkins. Okay, there you go. We've got our one diamond preserved and our marble and stuff like that, which gives us some tokens to trade with in the future if we'd like. Iron situation has been fixed. The log situation has not been fixed, really. He is producing more tools now. Or she is producing more tools now, but it's not perfect. How are the farms doing? Still not collected these ones, hey? Fine, that's fine. Very annoying, actually. Now and for the foreseeable future, we are so sorted on food. The real issue is logs. I don't think it can keep up with the supply and demand of this whole village, so I'm going to put an extra iron worker there, and we can just take him off and put him on when we need him. I think I mean blacksmith by iron worker. Yeah, see, look, we lost all of this crop. Like, all of this is just wasted, but we're still fine. Yeah, we do need more stone, don't we? Okay, no stone there. I was hoping to clear out that area of stone. Where's the nearest, most... Oh, they finished. Well, yeah, I will put two labourers in the quarry. And then we'll clear some stone as well. We shouldn't have another housing issue for a couple of years. Because we... Basically, it happens in ebb and flow here. You get one generation ages up, and then the next generation ages up. We're not... Oh, another person died during childbirth. This is annoying. Stop dying. It's a good job we've got a cemetery anyway. Yeah, because it's 1 year to 1 year, and when you move up the population, a bunch of babies are born. When you expand, a bunch of babies are born. The more you expand, the more often you'll have large amounts of people giving birth and needing to move up their houses. So I've done it once, basically. So it shouldn't happen again for a while. There are a few people who could do with houses now, and I'm not going to do that because it'll put us a little bit out of sync. Hey, hey, no one's planting. Why is no one planting? What are you doing? We were paused. That's why no one was planting. I was panicking. Okay, I was yelling at my farmers for nothing. But they were frozen in time anyway, so it didn't really cause an issue. I don't like the changes they've made to this market, but it is a central market, so I understand that it's different. I should have put a rural market down, really, but this is going to be a lot of like food production. So it's okay for there to be a large market. Let's clear out the area where this town is going to continue to grow into, because we need the logs, and also it's just a little bit hard to see what I'm doing, where I'm placing things. You know what? Just clear out everything. Where's the clear everything button? It's this one. Clear everything out of this area. Just going to cancel the removal here because I forgot that this is part of the tree farm. Oh, okay. We've got two things going on. First, anything we want to trade. Wadshine rum. Yeah, we'll trade for however many you'll give us. And we'll trade you pumpkins to do it. 528 pumpkins. I hope you've got a big ship, mate, because pumpkins aren't small. More pumpkins, and we got some more nomads. So, how many nomads exactly? 10 nomads! It's so many labourers! It's so many labourers! I'm totally going to do it. Oh, no. That was probably a bad idea. Right, let's handle the nomad crisis. Build houses, first of all. There you go. That should be enough houses. I put loads to be built here. Next, set a bunch of them to be stone farmers. I love calling them stone farmers. I love the idea. And then, we don't need to... I was going to add some more to be farmers, but we don't... Yeah, okay, we'll have more farmers. Just two more, though. And that'll help out with the crops. No diseases so far. And everything's growing up. Everything's... we're getting more stone, more iron. How much stone are you producing now? Okay. Well, not much, but still. Good enough. Whew. I think we're out of our diciest patch. Oh, the reason everything's going up is I told them to destroy everything here. That's fine. Also works. Okay, they're still working on clearing everything out, but it's going pretty well. We should have these houses soon and solve the... Well, we're not going to solve the housing crisis before winter, which is a shame, but also won't cause us huge amounts of hassle. The extra labourers we have should help out with clearing this, but I think they've got other jobs to be doing, so they might not in the end. I think, for the first time ever, we're about to have one field completely cleared before anything disappears. I mean, I might be wrong. I think two of those might have disappeared, but I'm going to count that as a win. 10,000 food is pretty solid. Okay, she's cold. That's understandable. Go in a house, please. Okay, good. She got warm. I need these houses to be built, like, now. Have we got our 5,000 pumpkins stored? Oh, we've got a trader. bricks, sand, stone tools. Yeah, let's. I'll do this. Well, he doesn't accept pumpkins, which is fine. This is where we trade up. You know what? I'll take the tools if we can afford them. Let's give him our gemstone and the marble. See if we can take the bricks as well. Okay, we're overpaying by 6, but that's fine. This guy's brought us some cool things. I'm going to release those tools into the population, and then everything else I'm going to keep. And I've also changed the number of pumpkins we require to a lot. Because we've got enough to have those pumpkins. Oh, there they are. Okay, I'll release the tools. Yeah. Can I order anything from him that will be useful? He doesn't accept pumpkins, so I'm not going to order anything from him. The next person who accepts pumpkins, I'm going to order everything I can from them. And then we can trade pumpkins to them for lots of stuff. Still no houses here. I guess I'll just put some of these to builders. Tools is not as low as you think it is, mate. We've just released 47 into the population. Well, 33. Oh, a lot of cold villages. This is the problem. We need them to get houses soon. Otherwise, I'm going to have to keep nipping into other people's houses to get cold. Which, firstly, should piss the other villagers off. But secondly, you know, it's just... It's a bit too risky. I don't know that they'll all make it back to other houses in time to save themselves. You know what? This market is not symmetrically placed. I mean, it couldn't have been because there's one here. Like, this is only one pathway wide. So I couldn't have placed it symmetrically. But it's so annoying. I'm not going to fix it, though. Okay, we've got one extra house built. Stop moving. I can't... Where's your job? You're a tailor? What's going on with the tailors then, hey? You guys are miles away. Oh, I didn't turn you on. That's why. I've got to turn my tailor on. There you go, she found her job. Tools is quite the opposite of low, thank you very much. Now I would like to set up some orchards. Since we've got some free time and free resources, like we're not struggling, I'm going to set up some orchards, which is a long-term payoff. But I think it's worth it. I'm also going to put a road in between the orchard farms and the traditional farms. Well, I suppose orchards are kind of traditional. But I mean, like, the farms and the orchards. The only reason I had that confusion there was because I used the wrong word. I said orchard farms, which is not a thing. This farm's in the wrong place. It's too large. Well, no, this farm's too small. I will totally destroy that farm and reset everything to make that farm the right way. There we go. Let's put in our first orchard. Okay, it took a while because of some poor placement on my part, but we've placed the orchards down and they should be built soon. We're doing a lot of resource clearing right now. Wow, look at our food. That's amazing. We're doing a lot of resource clearing. Oh, there's a trader. I forgot. What have we got? Yeah, I'll trade you some woodshine rum again. Cinder tape pumpkins. 528 pumpkins is fine by me. We have 8,000 to spare. That's crazy. We have 8,000 pumpkins stored and still 12,000 food. Let's order, then, everything. And we will trade this guy for whatever we can take next time. We're running up against our schoolhouse's capacity, which is fine because I think we'll be able to build a new one here. I don't know if we can build a new schoolhouse and shut the old one down without losing students. I don't know about that. We'll cross that bridge when we come to it. Okay, there's this area completely cleared, which is a huge boost in resources. Like, we've got a ton of logs now. We're not going to have trouble with logs for a long time, and hopefully by that time these guys will be in a much better position. Still haven't solved that homelessness problem, because I'm waiting on these houses to be built. They're taking a long time. So, one of the things we need to solve right away is the faith problem. So we haven't got enough church. I'm going to build a second chapel. Make sure it's a thematically accurate chapel. Nope. I don't like them when they look wrong. There we go. That's the right chapel. I'm going to put a chapel here because this place has got a lot of population now. Chapel's not really going to sit symmetrically either, which is a shame. I realised in time that we can at least make the chapel symmetrical with this road here. And then maybe if we get an opportunity to change or move the market in the future, we can. We will. So let's stick the chapel back down. Spend a while getting the right chapel again. Okay, chapel's down and should be off and running soon. We have a trader. What can you give us, mate? Ooh, wow, lots of stuff. Yeah, and he takes pumpkins. So I tell you what, let's just take as much of everything as we can. Well, actually, it exhausts exactly half of our supply of pumpkins, but you know what I mean. And is there anything we want to order from him that we couldn't get from anywhere else? You know, not really. I mean, he's already going to come back and we can trade the things we want to trade with him. No, I'm going to dismiss him. And then sort these all out in our inventory. Okay, there we go. Frog's legs, pickled eggs. We've got a lot of things. We could have a feast if we wanted one. You are going. Not very well. Not very fast, but you're going. These resources are very gradually being cleared, so we'll be able to start on our orchards pretty soon. And I'm going to put several down. In fact, I might even just set all these resources to be cleared out now, because I know that I want to use all of this space for orchards. There we go. Or most of that space, anyway. We're now back to the traditional 5 builders, 5 labourers. I'll have to move this at some point, and I'm going to put it by the quarry, I guess. But not right now. We are just on the edge of intersecting with the forester's lodge, like these trees here. So this is the furthest this village is going to extend. Standard pasture has been developed in infestation. There's nothing grow. Oh, pasture. A pasture! One of our... Okay. Now, what do you do about that? I don't know how that's handled. Do we kill the animals? Okay, here's what we do. We split some cows into the other pasture. And then if those guys die, honestly, I don't know what to do about it. So if these guys get killed by the infection that this pasture has, we'll have cows left, is my thinking. Do you have to just shut this pasture down? Another pasture? Or the same pasture? Okay, it's this pasture. So that didn't really help, splitting them off. I don't know what you do about it. What do you do about it? I googled it. So I'm going to empty this pasture, and I'm going to let them be taken in by this pasture, and then I'm going to set you guys to sheep. You need to empty, though. I need to empty this pasture. Okay. What we're going to do is, because I was going to move the pastures anyway. We're going to find a new place we're going to move them, and then we'll sort out the pastures into other places, and that'll stop the infection from spreading. Where to put them, though? Because we're sort of running out of space in all the areas I've traditionally worked. Okay, there we go. We're going to stick a pasture right in the center of this place. And then we're going to empty our cows into it, and we should be good, I think. I mean, this is not where I want the pastures, but also I no longer know where I want the pastures, because I've put a forester in the place where I would have put the pastures, I think. So I might end up moving the forester, probably. Don't our fields look nice? Oh, homelessness problem's been solved. I didn't even notice. So these guys have all got homes now. That's great. And they'll start breeding soon. Yeah, we'll take everything you have to offer. Thank you. Okay, I'm not taking the pepper seeds because I don't want pepper. I don't need pepper. Might be a good idea to diversify our food again, but I'm not worried about it. Though maybe that's the decision that's going to come back and bite us in the ass, because maybe we'll get an infection in our crops. We'll have to rotate our crops, but I don't know if that can happen in this game, honestly. It's just happened in our pasture, so I'm assuming it can happen in crop fields too. Oh, someone died. Okay, so let's make you cows. And then let's empty the cow pasture. And let's change you to sheep. No, actually, you know what? You're going to be... Yeah, we'll change you to sheep. Because we want a lot of sheep. Where the hell are the rest of the farmers? Okay, there's only 4 farmers here. Get back to work. Half of them were laying about doing nothing. Okay, that's fine. Scarlet fever is not fine. Where is the scarlet fever? Where's the scarlet fever? Hey. Okay, it's in the schoolhouse. You know what? If anyone's gonna die, I'd like it to be the children, in Banished, because, especially the students, because they're not doing anything for us. Just go into hospital though. It's fine. Don't touch anyone else on the way. Thank you. Okay, all our sheep are moving into here, which is good. I said empty. I'll change you over to horses and empty these horses. Then we've got more horses, and I can delete this pasture. So what's wrong with her then? Okay, everyone's doing their jobs now. We've got a bigger pasture for the horses. The infection of the cows has sorted itself out. I think we lost quite a few cows to it though. Fortunately, the meat we were getting off the cows will be replaced by the sheep, because the sheep have got a larger pasture now, so they'll catch up pretty quickly. Fix that. Good. That issue's solved. We were... Our iron mine wasn't working because we had run up against the limit. So I've just increased the limit because you never have too much iron. I'll keep increasing it, actually. Oh, someone else has died. Stonecutters is a dangerous profession. Okay, we're going to try and branch out our resource production a little bit. Oh, I just noticed we're losing a lot of food, but that's because the farms... because I traded so much... pumpkin away that this is trying to restock the pumpkins to back up to 8,000, which I think we can handle. If we can't, I've made a mistake and we're going to be screwed, but I think we can handle it, so no worries. And I bet there's a lot stored in here. Yeah, there's enough stored in here that it's not going to be a problem. We'll see though. So the last thing I'm going to do here is that I want to diversify our resources a little bit. So I'm going to build an apiary, and that's going to be in this village. I have to put the roads in so that I can see where I'm going. Oh, we've got another trader. What are you trading for? I'll take one watermelon seed. In this case, I should have taken the other seeds, but... Will they even... No, I'm not going to take it. They won't even grow in this climate. Ah, oh, I should have ordered from him, though. Oh, well. Yellow fever. You need to get to the hospital, like, right now. Where are you? God, you're miles away. Well, hopefully that means he's not going to touch anyone else on the way. Yeah, food's gone right back up, so no problems there. Right, apiary, and then we'll end the episode. I'm just trying to decide where to put him, or her. Yeah, I guess in this corner of town. And we'll put the candle maker right next to him, because I think the candle maker needs that as well. Well, obviously it's wax. Well, actually, I'm assuming, I don't know. Okay, let's. While our apiary is building, I will end the episode. Because we've done a lot, made a lot of progress. We've kept our people alive, and we've sorted out our food. We're no longer having resource problems, but that won't last long, because... it was just that we cleared out a large area of resources. Until next time, this has been Gesture of None. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. If you have, don't forget to like and subscribe. And also leave a comment below if you've got any ideas or suggestions. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time.